Hello, everyone. Welcome. And today is December 20th, 2023. It is hump day. I am Solid Blue Sister, and this is My Turn to Talk. And as always, whatever platform you are listening, be it live or on the replay, thank you very much. Always much appreciated. Welcome, welcome. And I do hope everyone's having a wonderful day. It is a beautiful, rainy, day in Southern California. Hey, Frankie. Brina, Brina. Hey, Lou, welcome back. Brina, you and Frankie always seem to show up around the same time. Not sure if you guys are going to like my outro song today, but we shall see. We shall see. Best non-GMO human. Welcome. Upload the song. Hey, Blunt, welcome. Hey, Faith, welcome. Okay, so let's get started. All right, so what people say versus what they think. Is there a difference? And I did put in there, I said, technically, yes, but. Let's start off with, do most people say what they really mean? You know, if you're thinking something, do you actually say it? And I know there are some things that we think that we should not say. Some people have learned to edit themselves and some people have not. Some people just blurt things out, you know, but Rita says, unfortunately, we can't curse out coworkers. Yeah. Lou says, I unfortunately do most times. But I mean, if we, you know, when we say things, do we really mean it? You know, do we have to translate what people say? Like, if you were to say, you know, if your mother, father, or whomever were to say, you should follow your dreams, are they really telling you, you need to go get a job, be more responsible? You know, and what people say, hey, Mama Bear, welcome back. You know, so when people say things versus what they think, are they being honest? So if they're thinking something, but they say something else, are they being honest because they're thinking it, but they didn't say it? Does that make sense? I know where I'm trying to go, y'all. So... Lou says, Brina, I'll give you pointers. I've been dealing with dumb lately at work, you know. So, I mean, can you curse out your coworker in a polite way? Is there a polite way to curse somebody out? You know, and, you know, if your coworker is being dumb, you know, why can't you say what you did was really dumb? Is it because you don't say those things at work? But if you guys were to go out after work, you know, to have drinks or dinner or something, you told them then that what they did was really dumb. Does it matter if you tell them at work as opposed to not on the property? Does it really matter? You know, when people wish you well, you know, when people wish you well, do they really mean it? You know, do they really, you know, wish that, you know, oh, good luck. Or I hope she runs into a tree. You know, I mean, do they really say what they think? Lou says, I don't even want to deal with my coworkers at work. Never off the clock. Well, yeah, you have people. Yeah. You know, when you're off the clock, you know, you are gone. You are gone. You know, when you say good morning, good evening to someone, do you really mean it? You know, are you that person who says what they mean? Are you that person who, when you say, you know, even if you say you're going to do something, do you do it? Do you follow through? Or are you that person who says, yeah, you know, I'll meet you, you know, tomorrow at 5, and you're always that person who never shows up? Or you're that person who promises to do something and you never do it. So when you say, so those people who promise to do something and they actually don't do it, in their head, are they thinking, well, I know I'm not going to be there. I know I have no intention of doing this. So I'm just going to tell them that. Hey, Daddy Hoff. Welcome, Philo. Welcome. You know, so yes, I say good morning to anyone everywhere. And do you mean it? I mean, for some people, is good morning just something that is so, you know, it's just something that we just say good morning, you know? Or are there some people who you don't say good morning to because you really, truly don't mean it to them? Beth says, there is always a polite way or kind way to get your point across, but it can take thought and time to figure it out. Most people just start spouting off. But are they spouting off what they're thinking in their head? Or are they, you know, I mean, do most people take time to really consider what they're saying to people? Or does it depend upon the situation? Why do some people just blurt things out? I mean, I know there have been times where I've blurted things out and I say, I didn't mean to say that. I mean, I was thinking it, but I didn't mean to say it out loud. You know, when people say, oh, that just slipped. You know, so are those things that you want to say, but you know, they just come out, but you don't mean to say them out loud? Bev says, yes, but that doesn't work well for me. Lou says, just never know when someone needs it can change their day. You're right. You're right. You're right. But for some people, okay, let me ask this. We talked about this, about how you greet people. If you say good morning to someone and they're always that person who has their head down and they don't say good morning to you or hi, how are you or whatever, does that mean that in their head they're thinking, I have no intention of saying anything to you? You know, how many times have you gone up to the cashier when you're checking out and you say, hi, how are you, or good morning or whatever? And they say nothing to you. All they do is just start scanning your items. You know, are they thinking to themselves, I just don't want this person to talk to me. Just let me get this customer out the store. I don't want to be here. You know, let me just scan it. And you know, why are they talking to me? Oh, she said something to me. Let me just stuff her stuff into a bag and get her out of the store. You know, are these things that people are thinking? Brina says, they may be lost in their thoughts, but it does hurt my feelings when I say good morning and they don't say anything back. You know, Brina, you said that the other day, and I get you when you say that it hurts your feelings, but again, I just think that those people are just rude. To me, those are the people who go through their entire day just, you know, just kind of in a funk. You know, they may speak to people, or they, you know, they may speak to people who they know, maybe. You know, I don't know. You know, but mostly, you know, I just think that it's rude because I don't think that it's a big deal to say to someone, good morning, or even if you smile or you nod your head, you don't even have to say anything, but just an acknowledgement. You know, if somebody's taking the time to say good morning to you, can you just acknowledge me? Can you just, you know, nod your head, smile, do something? You know, but, when people do that small talk, you know, when people say, how are you? Do they really mean it? Are they thinking in their head, I could care less how you are. This is just something that just comes out of my mind, or I'm sorry, comes out of my mouth. When I say something, I just say, how are you? But I could really care less how you are. You know, so again, I go back to, do people really mean? Do people really mean what they say? And Blunt says, I mean it. So do I. Because I'm that person that if I don't want to talk to you, I'm not going to open my mouth. I will not say one word. You know, and I'm also that person who, if I say I'm going to do something, I do it. And if I cannot do it, I will tell you that I cannot do it. I will not leave you hanging. And if I don't want to do something, I will tell you I don't want to do it. Brina says, I usually say, how you doing by default? Most people say good, but I listen if they went into a story. Okay. So Brina, let's talk about that for a moment. Hold on. Let me read what Lou says. Lou says, at the public supermarket, employees must greet customers at 3 feet rule is actually a corporate policy. Yeah, a lot of companies now are saying, you know, hi, how are you, or good morning, or whatever, or welcome when people come into the store. Okay, so you say by default, most people say good, but I listen if they went into a story. I want to know if people, okay, if you say, how are you? Because there are some people who I say hi to. I don't say, how are you? Because I don't want to hear their story. Because they will go into a long, drawn out story. And usually it's a negative. It's something that everything that's wrong in their life. And I know who those people are. So I just say, hi. Because to me, if you say the how are you, you're asking them a question and you're opening it up for them to give an answer. So, you know, yeah, I care about how they're doing. Just saying, most people say good, fine. Okay. Oh, yeah, I can't deal with the chronic complainers. But even, you know, I mean, even if they're not, I mean, you just have those people who, as soon as you say how are you and you ask that question, even if they're not saying something that's, oh my God, my back hurts and I need to go to the doctor. I mean, some people will just, they'll just keep going on and on and on. Even if it's something good, it's like you're saying to yourself, when do you stop? You know, and to Blunt, when you say, you know, that you mean it, when you say, how are you? Do you say that to everyone? Do you say that to everyone? You know, would you say that to a boss that you don't like? You know, when you say, how are you? Do you really care how that person is? That coworker, that cousin, that family member, whomever, do you really care if you don't care for that person? So do you say, how are you? And when you're saying it, is that what you're really thinking? Are you really thinking how they are? You know, you're really asking how they are when you really don't care for that person. Liz says, just happens to me all the time. No, that was no. Liz says, I have no choice but to cut them off and go back to work. If I ask, I care. Okay. All right, Blum. All right. Rena says, if you never, ever find at least one good thing about life, I'll learn not to ask how they're doing. And Blum says, okay, I don't ask if I don't care. Okay. All right. Okay. Would you say that most people are like that, that most people don't ask if they don't care? Or do you think that most people are just so, it's just, you know, just something that people are so used to doing? Hi, how are you? Hi, how are you? Hi, how are you? You know, but they really don't care. You know, so, you know, when people say to you, I'm no expert, but, what do they really mean? If they say something like, I don't know. You know, they always have that but after it. And I say that to say, you know, going back to, do people really say what they think? Are people being honest if they don't say what they think? What they're thinking? Is it dishonest? Or is it just a way not to hurt someone's feelings, or another way to possibly curse out that co-worker without cursing them out? Now, Beth says, you know, said that there was a nice way to say things, but hey, Juju, welcome. And welcome, Big. You know, so let's see, I'm sorry, my thing jumped. I think this is a courtesy thing to do, but I can't talk for 20 minutes. So if someone is standing there and they're holding you up for 20 minutes, are you saying to yourself, I wish this person would shut up, or, you know, when are they going to stop? Or are you saying to yourself, I need to get back to work. I can't talk for, you know, I can't talk anymore. So can you just say, I'm sorry to have to interrupt, but I need to get back to work? Or are you thinking, I wish this person would shut up? Well, thank you for coming, Big. Hall says, my career consists of starting or responding to small talk. When I have to go, I just interrupt them, say I have to go, and most understand. Okay. All right. I say I'm honest 85% of the time. Okay. So the other 15%, Hoff, the other 15%, are you not honest most of the time because you don't want to be rude? Or you don't like the person? Or, I mean, 15% is to be polite, even though I don't mean it. Okay. You answered my question. Lou says, someone told me yesterday the stuff that comes out of my mouth sometimes is wild. I mean, I think that we all say stuff that, you know, comes out of our mouth that we shouldn't say. You know, like I said, I know stuff comes out of my mouth sometimes. And, you know, sometimes you catch yourself before you say it, you know, and some people have learned to edit themselves and some people haven't. But would you rather be around that person? Would you rather be around someone that literally told you what they think? 100% of the time, the person always told you what they think. I only just like that movie a couple years ago with, I see his face, but I can't think of his name. You know, that he, for 24 hours, he can only tell the truth. You know, would you want to be around that person who will always tell you what they're thinking? Even if it hurts some feelings. But that person's always being honest and you always know where that person's coming from. Lou says, I prefer people be honest with me. Maybe I am wrong sometimes. I mean, me personally, I would rather be around people who, at least for to me, always told me what they thought. And some people do. But do you need to have a thick skin for that? I mean, if you're that sensitive person, are you going to be able to listen to someone who, if they told you the truth, what they were thinking in their head 24 hours a day? Are you that person who's going to get upset? And then after those 24 hours was over and they went back to the way, you know, they were, would you always be thinking, well, are they telling me the truth? You know, Lou says, I'm sorry, Daddy Hoff says, I agree with that. Lou says, did you everywhere? Just got to look in good spots for it. Where's the money? You know, so, I mean, I don't know, because again, if people really say what they think, would we be better off as a society? If everyone went around telling people what they really thought, would we be better off as a society? Brina says yes. Hey, Minnesota. Welcome, my friend. You know, so, you know, I you know, if you know, just like they say, the devil you know versus the devil you don't. I mean, wouldn't you really want to know what your neighbors thought about you if you have to interact with them all the time? What your boss really thought? Your coworkers really thought? Would your work, if you don't like your job, would it be easier for you if you knew what everybody around you at your job thought of you? Would that make your job easier? I mean, if you were someone who really, you know, disliked their job, but you knew that everyone around you knew for a fact everyone around you really liked you, would that make your job easier? Then again, if you knew everyone around you didn't like you, would it make you want to quit? Okay, and Brina says, I'd like to know the truth regardless. You know, because, and do you find yourself that there are some people in your life, be they close to you or not close to you, that you can tell them what you're really thinking? Even if there are some hurt feelings, that you can tell them what you're really thinking. Because you do have those people that you have to tiptoe around. I have people, you know, that I have to tiptoe around, and I find myself, you know, I don't interact with those people much anymore. Because you always have to be careful what you say, how they're going to take it, because they're sensitive. And for me, it's like, if I can't be myself, if I can't, I mean, I'm not saying I'm going to come out and say, oh my God, you know, whatever, you know, but, you know, for me personally, I just find that, some of the sensitivity is just a bit much, because I find that those same people are not so sensitive when they're talking about other people. Hey, Power Girl, welcome. I didn't see you pop in. Welcome. You know, so I just, you know, again, go back to, do people really mean what they say? Do people say what they think? You know, if someone says, correct me if I'm wrong, do they really want you to? And if you did correct them, would they get mad? You know, I mean, would they? Correct me if I'm wrong. And then you go to correct them. Well, you didn't have to say that. You didn't have to do that. You know, but you have those people who are just, you know, they don't really mean what they say. And people say, I'll call you. Do they really mean it? You know, you're on that first date. The guy says, I'll call you. Will he really? The guy asks the girl, can I call you? And you say yes. And the girl knows doggone well she doesn't want to see this guy again. So she gives him a fake number. Instead of going through all that, why just say, you know, can I call you? Well, you know, I think we should probably go our separate ways. Or the guy doesn't even say at all, I'll call you. Just say, thanks for the evening and go on. Why even say the whole I'll call you? Or if the girl asks for the guy's phone number, can I call you? And the guy doesn't want to hear from the girl anymore. You know, just say, no, I think that, you know, we didn't click. Because would you rather tell someone that you don't click or whatever on that first date while you're there, as opposed to getting pissed off because he didn't call? Or getting pissed off that she gave you a wrong number, or he gave you a wrong number? That would piss me off more. I'd rather you just say, you know what, Solid, it's just not working. You know, it just didn't work. You know, yeah, your feathers may get a little ruffled, but it's over with. It's done. You keep on going. Gigi says, I expect people that want to correct me if I'm wrong. Okay. Exactly. Right. Why waste the time? Why waste the time? But you have people that do that. So when we talk about wasting time, if we don't say what we really think, are we wasting time? Are we wasting time? Are we wasting somebody's time if we're not saying what we think? If we're not really telling somebody what we think, are we wasting somebody's time? You know, if I say, you know, I'll call you, does I'll call you still translate into I'm going to text you? Because there's a difference between a call and a text. calling someone means you have to actually talk to that person. You have to interact with that person on a personal level. And you're texting them. You don't have that interaction. You don't have to go there. If someone says to you, let's get together soon. I had someone tell me the other day, let's get together after the new year. I'll call you. I know doggone well that she's not going to call me. I know she's not. And I'm like, oh, okay. You know, whatever. It went in one ear and right out the other. Because I know that she won't. Am I upset about it? No, because I know she won't. I'm not. It's not something that I'm going to dwell on. Now, if she happens to do it, I'll deal with it then. But right now, I'm not holding my breath that this person is going. I'm going to call me. You know. So when someone says, "Let's get together soon," do they really mean it? If someone says, let's get together soon, would you not make a date right then to get together? You know, I haven't seen you in a while. You know, what are you doing next Tuesday? What are you doing next Saturday? Because when you say, let's get together soon, whose onus is it to move forward? Is it the person that's saying it? Should they be the one that contact you, or are they waiting around for you to contact them? How many times have people said to you where you've invited someone and people have said, oh, I need to check to see what my daughter's doing, or I have to see this, or I have to check to see if I have to work, and they never call you back? People have done that to me. You know, I'm like, okay. Because to me, it's like, if you're going to check to see what your time allows, shouldn't you be calling me and because you're checking? Juju says, I always got a man's phone number. After I checked the number out, always under a female's name, I was throwing the number away. Bye, Felicia. Could have been his mother, Juju. He could have been living with his grandmother. Could have been his auntie. So, and if you say, it's good to see you, do you really mean that? Do you really mean that it's good to see someone? I mean, when you think of all the things that people say, you know, during the course of a day, how many people really mean it? Do you think more people mean what they say, what they're thinking, and they are what they say is what they're thinking? Or do you think that more people, I'm not going to say they're BSing you, but, you know, they don't mean it? If someone says, we'll keep you in our thoughts, will they really? That boss who says, we'll keep your information on file. And as soon as you hang up the phone or whatever, the file is the garbage can. I mean, you as a boss, do you really, you know, keep that person on the back burner? Are they on the back burner because there's someone that you couldn't hire them this time, or they didn't work out for this particular thing this time, but you're interested where you want to, you know, just keep their information around? Or, you know, when people say that, you get up and you walk out of that interview, or you hang up the phone knowing doggone well that you're never going to hear from that person again. Juju says, sometimes I would waste my time and call a number and ask them who is female name and they would be lost for words and couldn't figure out how I knew that. Okay, Brandon says, when I say I pray for someone, I really do. You taught them a lesson for the next time they tried to play someone, though. Maybe not, Brandon. Because how many women or men would actually follow up on a number? Oh boy. So I don't know. You know, people say a lot of things. When people say it's nice to meet you, is this something that you really mean? Does the average person really mean it when they say nice to meet you? What if that person is walking towards you with a mutual friend, and the person who they're about to introduce you to is someone that you don't like, or someone that you've seen around you don't care for, and they introduce you? Do you say nice to meet you? Brina, this is Juju. Juju, this is Brina. You know, do you say nice to meet you when you don't like the other person, or you don't care for the other person just from what you've seen from afar? Or you just say hi? Nope. It depends, and then nope. You know, so, or, you know, so do they at least get a hi? Do they get a grunt? Do they get something? Or you just look at them? I'll say, hey. Oh, hey, to be cordial. It's forced interaction. And nope. You know, so, you know, when you have that forced interaction, is that when all the stuff comes out of your mouth that you absolutely don't mean? Or sometimes is it better just to walk away? I mean, how many people have actually told someone that they don't care for, that they don't care for them? I mean, how many people have actually done that? How many people have actually, you know, told people that I, you know, I don't care for you? Brina says, I'm rarely mean. I'm great at walking away and ignoring people. Minnesota says me. Yeah, I know you have. Gigi says, out of respect for a third party, I will be cordial. Okay, and Brina says the same. Okay. So what if that third party knew you didn't like that person or didn't care for that person, and they still brought that person and introduced you anyway, or they didn't bring that person to your house, but you guys were at a mutual function, and they weren't necessarily bringing that person, hey, shorty. And Mr. A, welcome. They weren't necessarily bringing that person. They weren't necessarily bringing that person to meet you, but that person came with them, and they were coming up to you to say hello. Do you just totally ignore the person that is with them, or do you say something? What if that person says something to you? When they say, hey, Juju, Brina, do you say something? Or do you just ignore them? And I will admit, there are people who have said hello to me, and I absolutely don't like that person, and I have absolutely ignored that person. Shorty says it depends upon the person. Okay. All right. All right. So it depends upon how much you dislike that person. Like, you just dislike them a little bit compared to if you dislike them a lot, Shorty, or I knew she was going to come up. Hey, Shorty.
Hey, Solly. How you doing?
I'm good.
It like I said, it depends on the people. You understand? And how much I despise that person. It can be a little bit. You understand what I'm saying? It don't gotta take a whole lot. If you rub me the wrong way, we was cool at one time, and then you rub me the wrong way, I ain't gonna say nothing to you. I'll bypass you. I'll say hi to you, skip you, and hey, everybody else, and that like you ain't even there. You don't exist.
Okay, so if you said to someone, let's get together soon, do you really mean it?
No. Why would I want to say that? I'm
talking about something. I'm talking about something totally different now. So if you were to see someone that you hadn't seen in a while and you said, let's get together soon, do you really mean it? Will you really make an effort to contact them to get together soon? Or are you just thinking it, but you just really, you know?
The catch up, yeah, I'll probably be like, we'll talk, you know, hit me, text me, you know what I mean? But then you actually do it, then you be like, dang, I shouldn't have said that because you don't even want to deal with it.
Okay, so then you're saying something that you're saying something that you don't really think.
Right.
Okay, so why say it?
I guess to make the person feel good, I guess.
Okay, but are they going to not feel good if you don't say it? If you just say, okay, well, it was good seeing you, and then that's it. And they just go, they go their way, you go your way. So why go through the thing about let's get together soon? Because then you put that expectation out there.
Right. That's true. Well, you set yourself up like that sometimes, and then you don't want to deal with it, and then you're like, dang, you just act like you forgot. You know, that's what they do. Oh, I forgot. I was going to get around to it. Like,
okay, so and this is all stuff that I asked before you came on. So if I say I'll call you, are you expecting me to call you?
Yes.
And if I don't?
Then you know you'll get that. Damn.
I mean, are you pissed at that point because I didn't call you?
See, did some ways I'll be mad, but then you be like, you gotta think they were probably busy. You know, they probably tell you, oh, I was busy, or I was doing this, I was doing that. You know what I mean? People have excuses. But then if you tell somebody I'm gonna call you back, you know, they're expecting that call back. But if they know you by now, she ain't gonna call me back. I ain't worried about it.
But okay, so if I say I'll call you, is there an expectation on the time limit? Like, what if I say I'll call you, but I don't call you until 3 weeks later?
See, that's something totally different. You know, you'd be like, I'll call you. You don't know when they're going to call. But if you put a time on it, people waiting on that time. Oh, yeah, that's a big difference, though.
Okay, so you just went out first date with this guy or girl, whatever. And they say, I'll call you. What is the time limit expectation that you have for that?
You think they'll probably call you tonight to let them know, you know, they got home safely, or text or something, or the next day. Then if they don't call either one of those days, you'd be thinking like, dang, it really wasn't. I guess it wasn't it.
So if someone says, I'll call you after a first date, and they end up texting you.
See,
I don't want to text. Okay. And I want a phone call. Because I think a text is not as personal as a phone call.
Yeah, but solid. If they busy, right, and they can't hit that green button to call you, and they hit you with a text like, hey, how you doing? Just thinking of you. You ain't going to text back? Hey, how you doing?
I mean, okay, you text back, but it's like, well, dang, you know, you said I can't even get a phone call. You can't say, hey, I mean, put it like this. If you're too busy to call me, then I'd rather you call me than I don't know. I'm sorry. After a first date, I don't want to text. I want a phone call. Okay, Shorty. Then let me put it like this. Let's take the smartphones out of the equation, okay?
Okay.
There's no smartphones. We going back to old fashioned. Everybody got a landline phone. Okay.
You gotta remember that number, write it down on a piece of paper.
All right. So you give them the number, whatever. They say they're going to call you. They don't call you, but a week later, I mean, for somehow or another, they got your address or something, and they send you a letter. Or they have your email. They send you an email. Would you take that over a phone call?
No. Okay, so
then why should I accept a text over a phone call?
But that's out of courtesy, though. If you text, then you'll hit them with that line like, dang, like, ain't heard from you in a week after that first day. You know, I thought it was me. And da, da, da. You could have texted me or something. You know?
Am I lying? I don't know because Brita says, yeah, if you're dating, that requires a phone call. And then she says the cord Brita, that cord did stretch.
It did. You walk around everywhere with it. Mm-hmm.
And then and like Brita says, nope, if we dating, call me. Seriously, call me. I want that phone call. I don't want no damn text.
True.
So you would accept. So okay. So you would be the person who texts then.
Who, me?
Okay, put it like this. Okay, put it like this. You guys went out. He said he would call you, and he called you. For whatever reason, you missed his call. But he left a message. He left a voicemail. Would you respond with the call, or would you text him back?
Oh, I'll respond with a call.
Okay. All right.
And then he'll pick up. I'm a text. And then call you again and text you and then leave you alone.
All right. All right. So Brina says texting is okay, but not primarily. All right. All right. All right. I don't know, Shorty. I don't know I don't want to date you if you gonna text me on the first date. So,
wow,
you know, so
I'll
you know,
call. I'll call you. You call me, whatever. But solid. How about if they call you and you miss that call, you call back and they'll pick up. You gonna text them, right?
I will text him to say that I tried to call you, you know, but at the same time, I'm not going to just keep texting back. I am going to try to call. I mean, I would hope that they, if they saw my text call and see that I tried to call, that they would pick up the phone and they would call me.
Right. True. That's true.
You know, so Brina says T9 back in the day was tough. Calls just made more sense. I mean, and I don't know. I just think that again. Okay, so let me ask this. I did ask the panel, but Shorty, since you're up here with me, I'm gonna ask you. Would you prefer somebody tell you after the first date that it was nice to meet you, but I don't think this is going to work out, as opposed to I'll call you and they never do?
I'd rather them tell me, because I don't want to sit there and with the expectations of assuming that we had a good time, you going to call me, and I'm up here just bragging and junk, and then you don't even call me. Right? You ain't really had no interest in me. I'd rather you tell me you don't have no interest in me, so I can move on from this situation.
Okay. Hey, Saturday Night Smoke, welcome. So, let me ask this one then. 24 hours. Somebody has to tell you exactly what they're thinking for 24 hours, no matter what it is, even if it may hurt your feelings. Would you rather someone actually really truly tell you what they're thinking, or?
Yes, I would rather them tell me. I'd rather them keep 100 me. with me, because if you really don't like me or it's something that bothers you about me, I'd rather you tell me that I'll probably be like, dang, like, I have myself thinking, like, okay, I need to switch up and do better about this and this and this, or change it, or you just say, forget about it. You understand what I'm saying? But I'd rather somebody be real with me than just beating around the bush and be fake.
Okay. All right. This is for Shorty. I mean, yes, yes, I would absolutely. I don't care if it's something that, you know, mean, whatever. I'd rather you tell me than me thinking that you, you know, think something else and you actually thinking something else. So absolutely, 100, 100. Okay, so this next question is for Shorty and for everybody on the panel. Y'all may not want to answer. Y'all may not want to answer whatever, but I'm getting into relationships here. So, in terms of relationships, do you think that most couples are absolutely honest in everything? That you all are having this talk, no matter what the talk is about, be it finances, sex, whatever, that you are. Shorty, what's all that banging?
That's my son messing with my Tweety dog. I'm trying to get it in.
So, okay, Sari says honest. No, I think most often some subjects. But Brina, if you have to soften, then that means are you being honest? I mean, do you think that most couples are honest? That if they're talking to each other and one ask a question about to another, are they actually saying what they think, or are they not necessarily being honest because they don't want to hurt? Does this dress make my booty look big? I mean, seriously, because I've asked my husband a couple of times. I said, do these pants make my butt look big? He'll look and he'll, you know, no, not really. You know, then the not, and then I'm like, not really. What, you know, what does not really mean? And then he starts laughing. He goes,
but I ain't gonna be real with you.
You know, so bad. I'm like, either it does or it doesn't. He goes, well, I don't know. What did he say? There were a pair of pants I kept looking at. I'm like, do I want to wear these pants? Do I not want to wear these pants? And because I kept looking at them, and I'm like, do they make my butt look big? And he was like, well, no, not really. And I'm like, well, again, so finally he said, well, I mean, he says they look nice, but there's just something about them. And they were from Kohl's. You know, you get those real cheap stuff from Kohl's after you use all your cash card and all the other stuff. I ended up taking them back. But Sari says, it's not the pants. Dang, smoke. It's not being honest, but sometimes it could be harmless. Yeah, he was trying. Yeah. You know, so I mean, but Crazy says, you see someone and say hi, do you keep saying hi throughout the day? That's a good question. No. No. Do I have to say hi to you every time I see you? I mean, so if you see that coworker, is it always hi, 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 hi? I mean, I said hi once. How many times am I supposed to say hi to you? I mean, what? Am I wrong? Isn't that the whole time you want your buddies to look big? Not all the time, Juju. Not all the time. Crazy said, that's what I say. I don't think so. I mean, do you all think that? Do you think that when you say hi to somebody, you see them throughout the day, you have to keep saying hi? I mean, you see them at the copy machine, hi. You see them at the coffee station, hi. You see them, you know, in the parking lot before work, hi. You see them in the restroom, hi. I mean, how many times do I have to say hi to you? But apparently I'm rude. Y'all probably think that I'm rude at this point. You know, so that sounds like stalking. Hello. I wouldn't say hi every time I saw somebody. I mean, I wouldn't expect someone to say hi every time somebody saw me. I mean, at some point I would think that, are you stalking me? Like, okay, it's, you get a little creepy, don't you think? Hi. So, yeah.
But does that still mean if it's a different way, if they say hi, they say hi one time and be like, hey, what's good? Is that still the same?
I mean, shorty, come on. Hey, crazy. Come on. How many times do you have to say hi to someone? I mean, I don't care if they say, hey, hi, hello, whatever. You said hello to me once, maybe twice, okay? But do I have to keep saying hi to you?
No.
So like I said, so it's that coworker at work. So every time you see them on the elevator, hi. You see them when you're coming back from lunch, hi. You see them, I mean, how many times are you going to say hi? I mean, I don't know. Fair says, I kind of feel like I dap up too many heads now and too frequently. I dap up to, I don't know what that means.
Like,
oh,
that's,
they
that's
get the
that,
head.
That,
okay.
That's another
okay,
way
the head nod.
Yeah, the
okay.
head nod.
Okay, but Fair, how many times do you have to nod your head? Juju says, people who went out and bought me their butts, of course, they want to be told they look bad. You still on the butt thing. Crazy says, I'm just checking. I can see you 10 times a day and I'll still say hi. Juju, then you know what? We're going to have to limit our face-to-face. Crazy lady says, making sure I wasn't really being out there all by myself. Crazy lady, I'm with you. Smoke says, I met a guy at a party for the first time ever, and I said hi to him 3 times because I kept forgetting I had already met him. I mean, okay, so if you continue to say hi to someone over and over and over, what are they really thinking? Are they really thinking, damn, would they shut up? Why do they keep saying hi to me? What is wrong with them? I mean, what are they really thinking? I've had this convo before because of my showrooms. You know, I mean, I'm just saying, I just don't, I mean, I don't, Now, crazy. Now, see, I will say, I mean, I just think that one time, it's like, how many times do you have to say hello to someone? Fair says, we're in this mess together, is what they're thinking. I don't know, y'all. I mean, again, you know, it comes down, you know, do people say what they think? So, okay, so you guys are out on a first date, and the guy says to the girl, or the girl says to the guy, I'll text you. How do you feel about that? Like, are they really thinking, I'm going to say text because I really don't want to contact you at all? Is that what they're really thinking? So instead of saying, I'll call you, they'll say that they'll text you, and then they conveniently forget to ask your phone number?
Yeah, if you really don't really want to hit me, and I hit you with that, I'll text you like, man, don't worry about it. I'm good. We good.
So, if someone says, can I call you? Do you think that they're being honest? That they really want to call you? Or do they think they're just being polite? And Juju says, I work with 1,200 people. Every time I saw a person throughout the day, I say hi. I don't care if I was telling the same person for 10 times. You have no idea how many weddings I got invited to. I don't even know the people. I am not a good texter or caller, crazy lady says. Okay. All right. But if someone calls you, I don't chit chat on the phone. Okay. But if someone calls you and you miss their call, or you purposely don't answer their call, do you owe them a call back just to be polite?
Hell no. Because if you don't want to talk to them, you miss that call or that text for a reason. You know what I mean? You don't want to talk to them. You don't want to deal with them.
Okay, right, so what if they left? Okay, but what if they left a voicemail or a text saying, "Hey, shorty, you know, I was just calling to say hi. I hadn't talked to you in a while. You know, I just wanted to say hi." Does that not deserve a phone call back?
Some people would call back and be like, "Oh, hey, sorry I missed your call, girl. You know, man, I was busy and this and that. What's up?" Then the other ones be like, "Man, F that. I'm not doing that. I'm good."
Picked up. Okay, crazy lady. So you say if it's important, they'll leave a voicemail. I don't leave voicemails unless they are for clients. I don't leave voicemails. If someone doesn't answer, I would just hang up, and I'll text them. So let's see. And then Crazy says, "Then I called me. I know I watched." Okay. "Them, I called me. I watched it ring." Okay. Maybe there's a text if there is a concern, but again, okay. And Juju says, "I always leave a voicemail." Okay. But again, they're just calling to say, "Hey, what's up? You know, just again, haven't spoken to you in a while. Want to, you know, just touch bases. How's the family? Whatever." That doesn't you can't call them back to say, "Hey, everything's fine." Then just cut the conversation short. Okay, but if I don't call you back, there's a reason. And Crazy says no. Okay. All right. So what if there's an emergency one time and you don't call that person back, or they don't, or you know, they'll say, "Well, she didn't call me. Why should I pick up the phone for her?" And it's an emergency on your side and you need them to pick up, but they're not picking up because of the way you treated them with their phone call.
See, that's the double standard right there, because stuff like that always happens.
Okay. Always happens. All right. And Crazy says, "If it's an emergency, then I better try harder." Mm-hmm. Oh, Lord. That's a true humbling. Yes, it is. You know, so, I mean, it hasn't happened to me in a phone call, but there was one particular time when I did not answer it. Like I said, it wasn't a phone call, but I did not acknowledge someone, and it was an emergency for me, and I needed them to acknowledge me, and they didn't, and I was SOL. So, you know, I mean, seriously, SOL. Yep, I would figure something out. Crazy says, "If it's an emergency, that person should have left me a voicemail and should have said that in the text." But if it's an emergency, nobody has time to voicemail a text. They're going to just hang up. And then, I mean, if it's an emergency, you're not thinking about all that. You're like, "I need to get something done right now. Who's going to help me," or whatever. I mean, if the ship's sinking, I'm not going to text you. I'm going to try to, you know, see if I can, you know, get somebody else to help or whatever. I don't know. Never truly depend on anyone. Crazy says, "Don't come back later. It was emergency. You just called me and then text me the words to say I called." Well, no, I mean, I don't think, again, if it's an emergency, I'm not going to text you and say that I called. I'm hanging up and trying to figure out what else I can do. I say that it takes 10 seconds. Okay, if it's an emergency, I will put ASAP emergency. Okay, all right. Well, guys, my hour is up. Oh, boy. And Shorty, like I said, I'm going to be taking you out on a date.
Because I'll be fun on the date.
Yeah, but after that first date night, and you know, or if you take me out, I take you out, and you say you're gonna call me, and you gonna text me, then you know, don't even bother.
No, I'll call you, and then I'll text you, and then I call you again.
But the first time, but you said the first time that you would text, and I'm like, no, I don't want that text. I want a phone call.
What I said was solid. I said if something come up and you get busy, then you can't call, you'll text.
Crazy says no day for shorty. Thank you, Brina.
It's okay.
Oh, my dad's ringtone was him through much from Star Wars. Oh Lord. Well, shorty. I tell you what. We may not have a date, but we can do a video chat.
Okay.
We can do a video chat. So, you know. Okay, y'all. My husband's here is an asshole calling. All right, so y'all may like this song, y'all may not like this song, but I am a Barbara Streisand fan, so this is a Barbara Streisand song, one of my favorites, my favorite duos that she did. So Neil Diamond and Barbara Streisand. And shorty, see, you wouldn't get a second date because you don't send me flowers, and this is what this is. You don't send me flowers.
I'm sorry.
Oh. All right, so here you go.
You don't bring me flowers. You don't sing me love songs.
You hardly talk to me anymore. When I come through the door at the end of the day,
I remember when you couldn't wait to love me. You used to hate to leave me. Now after loving me late at night,
when it's good for you, you're feeling all right.
Well, you just roll over and turn out the light. And you don't bring me flowers anymore.
It used to be so natural. Talk about forever. What used to be's don't count anymore. They just lay on the floor till we sweep them away.
Baby, I remember all the things you taught me.
I learned how to laugh and I learned how to cry. So you think I could learn how to tell you goodbye?
You don't bring me flowers
anymore. Don't say you need me,
and you don't sing me love songs.
You don't bring me flowers anymore.
Well, that's it, everyone. Thank you very much for coming today. As always, much appreciated. Shorty, thank you for joining me on the panel. And thank you for everyone for liking the show. I will have open discussion over at my other house tomorrow. So other than that, you guys, enjoy the rest of your day or evening wherever you are in the world. And for people who are here for the first time, thank you for coming. See you tomorrow. Bye.